الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس من طال عمره وحسن عمله أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم My dear respected brothers, elders and friends, it is a great honor and blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon all of us that we are sitting in the house of Allah talking about His great deen, talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talking about His beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are sitting in the house of Allah, which is the most beloved place to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَحَبُّ الْبِلَادِ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَسَاجِدِهَا The most beloved place to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the masajid. So, alhamdulillah, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us ability, tawfiq for sitting in the house of Allah. Alhamdulillah. Al-masajidu buyutullah. Masajid are the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tudiyu li ahli sama. These gathering and masajid are shine to the dwellers of the heavens, to the angels, just like the stars shining for the dwellers of the earth. And whoever loved masajid, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, because masajid are the house of Allah, man alifa al-masjid alifahullah. Whoever loves masajid, Allah will love him. And who loves the masajid, obviously, he will be coming to masjid frequently. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with glad tidings. من غدا إلى المسجد أو راحة أغدى الله له نزلا كلما غدا وراحة Whoever come to masjid in the morning or in the evening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare for him good hospitality in paradise. Allah ta'ala mehmandari paida ho. Not only that, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be glad tidings. Like we just performed Salatul Maghrib in the darkness of the sunset. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Bashir al-Mashra'in ila al-Dulam ila al-Masajid bin Nuri Tabmi yawm al-Qiyamah. O my Nabi, give glad tidings to those people who goes to masjid in the darkness of the night. What is the glad tidings? Allah will grant them complete noor, light on the day of judgment. These darkness will transform into light. So brothers, alhamdulillah, who loves masjid, he will frequent to the masjid. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ Masajid are visited by those people only. Those people will maintain the masajid, the house of Allah. Those who believe in Allah, believe in hereafter, and they will be establishing the salah. They pay zakah. وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And they will not fear anyone beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ أَن يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْدَدِينَ These are the people expected to be on true guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers, alhamdulillah, we have prayed Salatul Maghrib. But there are so many people living in our society. They have no concern at all. They have no attachment to the masjid. They don't pray. Whereas Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, Al-ahadu alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah. The things difference between Muslim and non-Muslim, the things which differentiate between Muslim and Munafiq, hypocrite, only performance of Salah. The person who performs Salah, he is a Muslim. وَمَنْ تَرَكَ فَقَدْ كَفَرْ Whoever abandons Salah, he becomes disbeliever. And Sahaba, it was a major sin because it's a pillar of Islam. Man aqama salah aqama ad-deen. One who established salah, he has established the pillar of deen. Wa man taraka faqad kafar. Whoever abandons salah, he become disbeliever, he become kafir. Kanu la yarawna shay'an min al-a'mal tarku kufrun ghayra salah. Sahaba ikram ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in, they did not consider any amal, abandonment of any amal to be disbelieving except neglecting salah. The person who doesn't pray, this to pinpoint that he is a kafir. He can't be a Muslim. The person who doesn't pray, he has no right to claim that I am a Muslim. So brothers, we should concern for other brothers. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yu'minu ahadukum hatta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsi." You cannot attain perfection in iman. You can never be a complete Muslim, complete believer, until what you love for yourself, you love for other people. Why we are praying? Because Rasul said, "As-salatu miftahul jannah." Salah is a key to the paradise. So we have to desire for Aram. This desire should be in ours. So other people, how can they come to the masjid? How can they attend this, obtain this key to paradise? So brothers, Salah. أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة من عمله الصلاة. First thing Allah will ask servant of Allah about his Salah. He will be questioned about first thing of Salah. فَإِن صَلُحَتْ فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَى. His Salah is seen to be sound, perfect, complete. فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَى. He will be successful and he will be safe from hellfire. وَإِن خَابَ. But his namaz is corrupt. He didn't pray. There is a deficiency. فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرْ. He'll be very unfortunate and he'll be ruined and he'll be loser. Allah is so merciful. Allah will say, إِن تَقَسَ مِنْ فَرِيدَتِهِ شَيْءٍ. If there's any deficiency, any shortcoming in obligatory salah, in fara'id, Allah wants to save him, Allah will command, أُنْذُرُوا هَلِّ عَبْدِ مِنْ تَتَوِّنْ. Has he performed any extra nawafil? Through this nawafil, Allah will made up obligatory salah. But is there not salah in his life, then he'll be ruined. So brothers, salah. We have to pray 5 times salah in punctuality. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahu Akbar, he mentioned so many fazail of salah. As-salatu mirajul mu'min. Salah is a mirajul mu'min. Silatul bayna al-abdi wa rabbi. It's a conversation between Allah, creator, and his servant. When servant of Allah say, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, then he start reading, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise be to Allah. All praise be to Allah, who is the cherisher of the world, Lord of this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer, reply, Hamidani abdi, my abd has praised me. When he said, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, most compassionate and most merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied, Asna alayya abdi, my abd has mentioned my greatness and he praised me. When he said, Malik yawmiddin, the possessor of the day of judgment, master of the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again said, what did he say? Atna majjadani abdi. My abd has mentioned my greatness and he praised me again. when he say, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ya Allah, only you we worship, and only you, you alone, we ask for help. When upset, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied, The hadha baini wa baina abdi nisfain wa li abdi ma sa'al. This is between me and my servant, half half. Iyyaka na'budu, this is his duty. Ibadat is for his duty. Nasta'in, madad and help only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, this is between half for me and half for him. Half he kept for himself and half of me. He's saying that whenever I want any help, Ya Allah, I will worship you and I will only ask help from you. And Allah said, Wa li abdi ma sa'ala, and my servant will get whatever he asks for. So brothers, how many times we repeat this in salah? Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Only you we worship and you alone we seek help. But in reality, do we have any connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We have no connection at all with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whereas Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught his sahaba ikram to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every matter, in individually collective need, they should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much so, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of his companions, Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, O Anas, whenever your shoelace break, before you go to Qabla, turn to Allah, make dua from him, then go to Qabla. And this is also Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to do same. Kana idha hazabahu amrun, faza ila salam. Whenever anything troubled him, he used to resort to the salah. He used to solve his problem through salah. But brothers, because weak of our iman, we don't have connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do we believe in that fact? That dua is a means of solving our problem? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught this hadith to one of his cousin, one of his sahabi, Abdullah ibn Abbas. When any crunch comes, brother, when we are cornered by any situation, we go to this person, we go to that person, we go to this mean, we go to that mean. This means and this thing will not help us against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِدُرِّنْ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts you with any heart, nobody can remove that heart from you. If Allah wants to open a door for you, nobody can close those doors. Walam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of his sahabi, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. O Ibn Abbas, when you ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. وَإِذَا إِسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. When you ask help, ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. Then he said, Father, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. O Abdullah, believe that if all the ummah unanimously, they get together to reach you some benefit, they cannot benefit you except by that which Allah has written for you. In other hand, if all the ummah get together and they want to harm you, they cannot harm you except by that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala written for you. Then he said, Father, ta'arraf ila Allahi fir raha ya'rifka fi shidda. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your prosperity, in good time, when time is easy for you, prosperity, ya'rifuka fi shidda, he will remember you in adversity, in your difficult time. وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ النَّصْرَ مَعَ الصَّبْرِ. And always Allah's help, always with patience, endurance. وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ مَا أَخْتَاكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُسِيبَكَ. And believe that whatever befalls you could not have missed you. And whatever missed you could not have befallen you. This is the Iman Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught one of his sahaba. So brother, we have to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dua. Dua is a ibadat. In fact, mukhul ibad, essence of ibadat. Do we allocate any time for the dua? We don't have time. Brothers, we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because only He is our provider. He is only our sustainer. He is the only one, He can solve our problem. Other than Him, nobody can solve our problem. This is Iman. So brothers, Alhamdulillah, we are Musliman. Muslim, Alhamdulillah. We have uttered La ilaha illallah. This kalima, such a big ni'mat, brothers. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahu Akbar. من قبل مني الكلمة التي عرضت على عمي فرد علي فهي له نجاة. One who accept this kalima, one who accept that kalima which I have presented to my uncle at the time of his death, he rejected. Whoever accept from me, this kalima will be means for his salvation. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوُدِيَتْ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فِي كَفَّةٍ وَكَلِمَةُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فِي كَفَّةٍ لَرَجَحَتْ بِهِنَّ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. If kalma was put on one scale, was placed one part of the scale, and seven skies, seven heavens, and seven earth were placed on another scale, the kalima لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ will be out there. In a hadith of Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَهَلُ الْجَنَّةِ جَنَّةِ. When people of Jannah, paradise, they will have entered the paradise. And people of Naar, people of hellfire, they will have entered into hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command to angel. He will command, أَخْرِجُوا مِنَ النَّارِ مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ مِّنْ إِيمَانٍ. Your angel, take out from the hellfire every person in whose heart there is an iman equivalent to the size of the mustard seed. Size of a mustard seed. There's an iman exists. Take him out from the hellfire and put him into Jannah. Allahu Akbar. This is the kalima. When kuffar see this, they will say, رُبَمَا يَوَدُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ كَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ. They wish they had been Muslim. So this is the kalima, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us, brother. We have to preserve it. We have to walk on this. So brother, what is La ilaha illallah? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is our creator. He is our sustainer. He is our protector. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't need our ibadat. He is in not need of our worship and ibadat. We are in need of Him. Ya ayyuhan nas antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. Oh people, you stand in need of Allah, but Allah is ghani. He is a rich. He doesn't need your ibadat. Wa antumul fuqara'. You need Him. And Allah is self-sufficient. All the commandments Allah has given us, brother, this is for our goodness, for our benefit. إِنَّكُمْ لَنْ تَبْلُغُوا دُرِّي فَتَدُرُّونِي وَلَمْ تَبْلُغُوا نَفِي فَتَنْفَعُونِي. Our worship and our disobedience, this doesn't benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither it harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّكُمْ لَنْ تَبْلُغُوا دُرِّي فَتَدُرُّونِي. Oh my servant, you will not be able to harm me and succeed in that purpose, and neither you will be able to benefit me in succeeding in such purpose. Then in hadith of Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibadi, oh my slave, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم ك كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل واحد منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. Oh my slave, ya ibadi, oh mere bande, if the first of you, last of you, jinn of you, ins of you, were pious as the one with the most pious heart amongst you, that will not increase in my kingdom, in my greatness a bit. In other hand, saying, if first of you, last of you, jinn of you, ins of you, everyone become disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will not decrease in my power, in my greatness, in my kingdom, even a bit. How, brother, he is a self-sufficient. In that hadith, at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibadi, O my slave, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا في صعيد واحد فسألوني. O my slave, if the first of you, last of you, jinn of you, ins of you, they were to stand in a vast place, in a one field, and they were to ask from me whatever they desire, and I was to give them whatever they wish, according to their desire, I grant them. ما نقص ذلك مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخية إلى أدخل. If I was to give everyone whatever they desire, that will not increase what I possess more than the needle when dipped into the ocean, then taken out. Ya ibad, innama hiya a'malukum. These are your action, your deed, good deeds. Uqsiha lakum. I'm putting them in your account. I'm preserving them. Thumma waqfikum iyaha. Then I'll give you full reward. فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. Whoever finds in his book of deed goodness, good outcome, he should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. Whoever finds other than this, he will not blame other than himself. So brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't need our worship and our ibadah. We are in need of him. So my dear brothers, Allah is our creator. He created us, not only us. Whatever we see, whatever we cannot see. Inna rabbakum Allah. Who is Allah? Your Lord is Allah. Alladhi khalaqa as-sama. Who has created seven heavens and earth. Fi sittati ayyam. In 6 days. Yughshi al-layla an-nahar. He brings the night as a cover over the days. Wash-shamsa wal-qamar. He has created the sun, the moon, the stars. Wal-nujumu musakharatin bi-amri. All of them are subjected to commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala lahul khalq wal amr. Listen, his is the command and his is the creation. Falillahi alhamdu rabbis samawat. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the sustainer of the heaven, sustainer of earth, and sustainer of the whole universe. Walahul kibriya. His is the majesty in the heavens and earth. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is a might and he is a wise. He is a wise. بَدِيعُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Originator of the heavens and earth. أَنَّا يَكُونُ لَهُ وَلَدْ. How can he have a son? وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ صَاحِبًا. He doesn't have any wife. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, he is our creator. And whatever he wish, he can do. إِنَّمَا إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَن يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever he wants to create something, he just say be and it becomes. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. Whatever you desire, that will not happen. What I desire, that will happen. In a hadith of Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya Abdi, Anta Turid. Wa ana urid. O my servant, you intend, I also intend. Wala yakunu illa ma urid. Only that will happen what I intend. Fa in radita, fa in sallamtani fi ma urid. If you are content, if you are pleased, if you are happy with my decision, what I intend, kafaytuka fi ma turid, I will be sufficient for your what you intend. وَإِلَّمْ تَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمْتُمْ. And if you are not happy, what I intend, أَتْأَفْتُكَ فِي مَا تُرِيدُ. Then I will make you tired in what you in your seeking. What you seeking, I will make you tired. وَلَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا مَا أُرِيدُ. But only that will happen, what I want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَن يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. Whenever he wants to do anything, nobody can stop him. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. O Nabi, say, O Allah, possessor of the sovereignty, تُوتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَىٰ. You give kingdom whomsoever you wills. وَتَنْزِغُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَىٰ. You withdraw sovereignty from whom you will. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. You exalt, you give honor whom you will. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. And you humiliate whom you will. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. All the goodness in your hand. تُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ. You are the one who passed the night into day, day into night. وَتَرْزُقُ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. And you give sustenance whoever you wills without any limit. Any limit. So Allah is the sustainer. You sustain any, everyone, brothers. وَكَأَيِّن مِّن دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا. How many moving creature there on this earth? They do not carry their sustenance with them. اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Allah is the one who provides them and you. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. O people, اُذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Remember the favors Allah has granted you. هَلْ مِنْ خَالِقٍ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِي. Is there any provider? Is there any sustainer other than Allah who sustain you from the heavens and the earth? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ. No, He is only Allah. He provides. In a hadith of Qudsi, Allahu Akbar. This hadith was written, like in Quran, there's so many beautiful verses. Similar verses of in Taurat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Yabna Adam, la takhafanna min di sultanin madama sultani baqiya. O son of Adam, do not fear from any sovereignty, any power, as long as my sovereignty is remain. And my sovereignty will never cease. It will remain forever. Yabna Adam, la takhafanna min di qil aish. Do not fear of heightening in sustenance. Ruzi ke andar tangi. Do not fear of that. Madama khazaini mal'an. As long as my storehouse, warehouse are full. O khazaini la yanfad abada. And my storehouse will never end. Yabna Adam. Khalaqtuka li'ibadati fala tal'ab. O my servant. I have created you for my worship. فَلَا تَلَبْ. Do not waste your time playing. Do not play. خَلَقْتُكَ لِعِبَادَتِي فَلَا تَلَغَبْ وَقَدَّرْتُ لَكَ رِزْقَكْ فَلَا تَتَعَبْ. And I granted your sustenance. I set a share for you in your sustenance. فَلَا تَتَعَبْ. Do not get tired. Do not tire yourself. يَبْنَ آدَمْ. خَلَقْتُكَ لِعِبَادَتِي فَلَا تَلْعَبْ وَقَدَّرْتُ لَكَ رِزْكَكْ فَلَا تَتَعَبْ فَإِنْ رَضِيتَ بِمَا قَسَمْتُهُ لَكَ. Such a beautiful verse. Oh my servant, whatever I gave you, granted you, if you are happy, if you are content, if you are content, you are happy, whatever I granted you, أَرَحْتُ قَلْبَكَ وَبَدَنَكَ. I will bring comfort, comfort to your body and your soul. وَتَكُونُ عِنْدِي مَحْمُودًا. And you will be praised by me. You will become my beloved. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمْتُهُ لَكَ. And if you are not happy, if you are not content, what have I given to you? تَرْكُدُ فِيهَا رَقْدَ الْأُخُوشِ فِي الْبَرِيَّةِ. Then what you are doing? You are running after sustenance, ruzi, just like an animal I will tarkudu fiha rakd al uhush fil bariya. If you are not content, then what I will do? Law sallatanna alayka ad-dunya. I will set the wall loose upon you. Main musallat kar dunga duniya ko. I will set the wall loose upon you. Then what will happen? Tarkudu fiha rakd al uhush fil bariya. Just as animal, they run in the wild jungle, they don't find any way out. Similarly, this will happen to you. And then, وَتَكُونُ عِنْدِي مَذْمُومًا, you'll be disgraced by me. Not only that, وَلَا يُسِيبُ لَكَ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبُتُهُ لَكَ, you will not receive more than what I have allocated for you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَبْنَ آدَمْ خَلَقْتُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَمْ عَيَ بِخَلْقِهِنَّ. Oh my servant, I have created seven sky, seven heavens and seven earth effortlessly. Tiredness didn't touch me even. أَفَيُعِينِي رَغِيفُ أَيْسًا أَسُوقُهُ إِلَيْهِ. Would it be trouble me to give you loaf of bread in your way? If I give you a loaf of bread two times, I'll become tired. يَبْنَ آدَمْ, Ya ibn Adam, la tas'alni rizqa ghad. Do not ask me tomorrow's sustenance. What you gonna have tomorrow, don't ask me. Just as I haven't asked you for tomorrow's salah, tomorrow's roza, I haven't asked you to advance anything for me. Fa inni lam ansa man asani wa kayfa man ata'ani. If I can provide all the disobedient people, you are my beloved one. Will I not provide to you? Then at the end of that hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibn Adam, inni laka muhibbun. Oh my servant, indeed I love you. Who's saying that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh servant, oh my ibad, oh mere bande, I love you, fabi haqqi alayka kulli muhibba. By the right I have upon you. By the right I have on you, I ask you, you also love me. You also love me. Brother, do we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Whereas, it's incumbent, it's not a nafal, it's not a mustahab, it's for us, upon everyone, to love Allah subhanahu. Ahib Allah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ahibullah, love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lima yugdikum min ni'ami, because He has granted you so many favors. Allahu akhrajakum min butuni ummahatikum la ta'lamuna shay'a. Allah is the one who extracted you from the wombs of your mother. He has granted you vision, and He has granted you hearing and intellect. La'allakum tashkurun, so you may become grateful to Him. Oh, time is running very fast, brother. Anyway, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us into this world. There is a purpose behind it. What is the purpose? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah has created us to recognize Him. We don't recognize Him. We don't love Him. Why? Because we don't know Him. Whereas Allah, how much He loves us? يَبْنَ آدَمْ, Allah is saying, ذَكَرْتَنِي ذَكَرْتُ. When you remember me, I remember you. وَإِنَّ سِيْتَنِي, when you forget me, still I love you, still I remember you. تُورِدُ عَنِّي وَأَنَا مُقْبِلٌ إِلَيْكَ. Sometimes you go away from me, you show me your back, but I still wait for your returning. When are you going to return? يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانِ مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. So brothers, we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He has granted so many ni'amat. So why Allah has granted all this ni'amat? So we can utilize all this in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother, this life is a temporary life. Very short life. Compared to hereafter, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah, fawallahi, main qasam khata hu Allah se. By Allah, this all is so insignificant compared to hereafter, just like one of you dipping his finger. فَوَاللَّهِ مَا الدُّنِيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا مِثْلُ مَا يَجَلُ أَحَدَكُمْ إِسْبُوَهُ فِي الْيَمْ فَلْيَنْظُرْ بِمَا يَتْلِ. خدا پاک کی قسم, this life is so short and hereafter is so vast compared to hereafter. This world is just like one of you dipping his finger into ocean. Then take it out, observing how much quantity of water is touching your finger. So that's why in the day of judgment, Allah will ask all disobedient people, kam labistum fil ardi adada sinin? How much, how many days or how many years did you stay in this world? They will say, labitna yawman aw ba'da. Oh Allah, you stayed for one, well, part of the day. Allah will say, ma labistum fil ardi illa qalil. You have not lived but very little. Then Allah will say, afa hasibtum annama khalaqnakum abata wa annakum ilayna la turja'un? What did you do? Did you think that we have created you without any purpose? And you will not return to me? No, brothers. We will all have to return to you. Minha khalaqnakum, wa fiha nu'idukum, wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. So my dear brothers, we have to prepare for hereafter. This is the purpose Allah has sent us to this earth. So we can make our Jannah from this world. Not to make this dunya Jannah. No. Our Jannah is Akhirah. Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, alam tara ila al-layli wal-naha. Maut brother. We have to prepare for hereafter. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-kayyisu man dana nafsuhu wa amila lima ba'da al-maut. Intellect. Very clever person in him who prepares for hereafter. But do we prepare for hereafter? Brothers, our great predecessor, Allahu Akbar. Look at Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. How pious he was. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ama tardain ay yakuna manziluka maqabal manzili. O Ali, does it not please you that your house will be in front of my house in Jannah? Such a personality. But look, he's crying for what? He's crying. And he used to say, Al-maut laysa minhu al-faut. The maut, death, there is no escaping from it. In reality, you cannot escape from it. If you oppose it, it will overpower you. If you run away from it will touch you. Aynama takunu yudrikkumu al-maut walau kuntum fi burujin mushayyada. In time of death, wherever you are, even if you are within a lofty construction, it will come, it will touch you. You cannot escape from the mood. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he used to say, address his nafs, he used to say, oh Ali, how little you have prepared for hereafter. How little position you have for hereafter. And how frightening is the way to hereafter. Brother, we have to prepare for hereafter. Alam tara ila al-layli wa al-nahar. Do you not see the alternation of day and night? Yabliyani kulla jadid. Every new thing is made old. Wa yatiyani kulla qareeb. And every far distant thing is brought near. When our child born, we seem that day is very far away. The day when he will be graduate from the university as a doctor, as a lawyer. But in blink of an eye, that time has already arrived. يَأْتِيَانِ كُلَّ مَغُودٍ. And every promise has been made reality. So brothers, Allah wale log, our great predecessor, they used to cry. When they used to depart from this world, they used to cry. Abdullah ibn Abbas, I am concluding. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala nu, he used to say, Kaifa an'am. Kaifa an'am, how I can rejoice. How I can rejoice. Wal mawtu wara'ana, wal quburu amamana, wa bayna yaday rabbina mawqina. How can I rejoice when maut is behind me and qubur, grave, is in front of me? Wa bayna yaday rabbina mawqifuna. When Qiyamah is haq, wa anna sa'ata atiyatul la rayba fiha, it will definitely come on its time. When Qiyamah is haq, and we have to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ala sirati mururuna, when we all have to cross bridge of the sirat. I don't know, can I cross or I fell down? When all this station marahil in front of me, how I can be? Look at our predecessor, great predecessor, Hazrat, Subhanallah, Hazrat Shafi, Imam Shafi, Rahmatullah Alayhi. Who never spend any second in disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they are dying, what they say? When one of his shagrid, one of his student asked him, Kaifa asbahata ya shaykh? Hazrat, how are you? Then what did he reply? Asbahtu min ad-dunya rahila. I have entered into mourning that I think I'm going to depart from this world. I enter into mourning in a condition that I'm going to depart from this world. Wali ikhwani mufariqa, and I'm going to leave my behind, I'm going to separate it from my companions, my friends, my brothers. Wali kasil maniyat shari. And very soon I'm going to drink from the glass of the death. Then he began to weep in the face. Such a big personality. He's big. Why is he crying? Allahu Akbar. How fearful he is. He said, La adhiri, ruhi tasiru ila al-jannati fawhadniha, aw ila al-nari fawhadniha. I do not know, should I congratulate my soul or I console my soul, because I do not know where he's going to go. He's going to go to Jannah or he's going to go to hellfire. This is fearful. The person who is the imandar, who got iman, iman will make you cry, brother. We are so content in our time. We don't have concern for hereafter. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna wada Allah haq. Oh people, listen. Inna wada, Allah's promise is a haq, definitely. Al-qabru haqqun, wal-jannatu haqqun, wal-naru haq. Inna wada Allah haq. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. This life of this world should not deceive you. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And let not cheat deceiver shaitan. He should not deceive you. Why? إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوُ. Shaitan is your dushman. He's your enemy. إِنَّمَا فَتَّخِذُوا عَدُوَا. Treat him as a your dushman, your enemy. إِنَّمَا يَدُوْ هِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُوا مِنَ الصَّعَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Shaitan, he always call his followers. So they can be dwellers of the blazing fire. So my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us to this world for purpose. We are servant of Allah. We are Abdullah, Ibadullah. So what is our duty? To serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should do all the commandments, fulfill all the commandments, do's and don'ts, and refrain from all the disobedience also. But we are also, brother, we are the followers of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Being a follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is our duty? Allah, how merciful Allah is. Allah has blessed us. We are followers of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't know our value, brother. Our Rasul, because of through blessing of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah has given us such a status. Allah has given us the title Umma khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin nar. You are the best of nations. Kyu na paaye teri ummat khayre ummat ka khitab? Kyu na paaye teri ummat khayre ummat ka khitab? Jab tu hai khairul bashar, khairul rasul, khairul anam. Why your ummat not be given the title of being best ummat when you are the best of creation, best of all the messenger, best of all the humanity? So my brothers, Allah has given us this title. Kuntum khaira ummatin ukhrijat minna. You are the best of ummat. Why? You do too many ibadat na, ukhrijat linnas. We are taken out for the benefit of mankind. Ta'muruna bil ma'ruf. What is that benefit? You call people towards ma'ruf. What is ma'ruf? All the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal mu'minuna wal mu'minatu ba'duhum awliya wa ba'd. All the believing mu'min and mu'min, male and female, they are one another, they are well-wisher, or you can say they are friends of each other. What they do? Ya'muruna bil ma'ruf. They call each other to the ma'ruf, commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are lacking now our time, brother. We are not fulfilling this obligation. This is our responsibility, to call people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us, I'm going to conclude it. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَوْنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. I swear by that being in whose hand Muhammad my soul is. You should invite, you should call people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and forbid from abstaining from the haram thing. Otherwise, what will happen? Allah will send punishment upon you. Then you will make supplication, you will make dua. Allah said, I'm not going to listen, I'm not going to respond to your dua. So brother, this is a responsibility on our shoulder. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is a hadith of Qudsi. Inna Allah awha ila Jibreel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command Jibreel alayhi wa sallam. Aniqlib madinata kaza wa kaza bihaliya. Oh Jibreel, go and overturn that city upside down with all the inhabitants also. Overturn the city with all the people, with all the people. Then Jibreel Amin went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submit. Oh Allah, this is your command that I should ruin that locality. O kayf fihim abduka lam yasika tarfat ayn. Wallah, there is your servant who never ever become disobedient to you even for blinking of eyes, who never disobey you even for the blinking of an eye. What is your command about him? You know what Allah said? Fabihi ibdail azab. That overturn the city on him with all the inhabitants. Why? فَإِنَّ وَجَهُ لَمْ يَتَمَغَرْ فِيَّ سَعَةً قَطُّ. When people are disobedient, people, they're carrying out all the sin, his face never ever changed in my disobedience. He doesn't get angry. So my brothers, this work, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the cream of all the prophets. So he was the last Nabi, he was the seal of prophethood. And we are the last ummah. So, antum khayruha wa akramuha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us. Alhamdulillah, make us his ummah. So, brother, this is our responsibility. In Hajjatul Wida, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked everyone. We heard this after Zuhur. He asked everyone, Hala hal ballagtu. Oh, my sahabi, have I conveyed to you on the commandments of Allah? Have I conveyed to you the full deen? Everyone said in one voice, بَلَّغَتَ الرِّسَالَةَ وَأَدَّيْتَ الْأَمَانَةَ وَنَصَحْتَ الْأُمَّةَ يَا رَسُولَ. Yes, Ya Rasulullah, you have conveyed to us. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? فَلْيُبَلِّغْ شَاهِدُكُمْ غَائِبَكُمْ. Now this is your responsibility. بَلَّغُوا أَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَا. If you know even one verse, one ayah, one good thing, convey to others. Who are present here, they should go and convey to the other people. So brother, this is our responsibility. And what Allah will give, only Allah knows. I'm concluding, I'm just finishing. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once, he said to one of his sahabi, what did he say? Abu Sa'id Khudri. Ya Abu Sa'id Khudri, man radiya billahi rabba, o bil islami deena, o bi muhammadin nabiya rasoola, wajabat lahul jannah. Whoever willingly acknowledge that Allah is my Rabb, he's satisfied, he's happy, Allah is my Rabb, and religion of Islam, Islam is as a religion, he's happy, and Messenger, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's Nabi. If he content, he's happy, wajabat lahul jannah, jannat become incumbent, jannat wajib ho jati. Hazrat Abu Sa'id Khudri, he was happy, he said, Ya Rasulullah, aida alayya, such a great, great hadith. Ya Rasul, can you repeat it again, please? Aida alayya, repeat it. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeated. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh Abu Sa'id, there is a yet another amal, through which Allah will elevate the status of a person by 100 ranks. 100 ranks in Jannah. Allah will give a person 100 ranks. How big? How big is the rank? Ma bayna samai. One rank from roof. One rank is from heavens and the, what is the distance between heaven and the earth? This is how big is that rank. Then when he said this, then Abu Sayyid Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked Ya Rasulullah, what is that amal? I want to go for it. What is that amal? Tell me. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-jihadu fi sabilillah. Al-jihadu fi sabilillah. That is striving in path of Allah. Striving in path of Allah. So brothers, this is the work. If you do it, Allah will bless us. Allah will resurrect us among Sahaba Ikram Ridwanullah Ajmain. والسابقون الأولون والمهاجرين الأنصار. In this ayah, Allah mentioned, whoever follows Sahaba Ikram Muhajirin Ansar, Allah will resurrect them among Sahaba Ikram on the day of judgment. So are we all ready for that, brother? We need to learn this iman, brother. We are very weak. We need to strive. Man jadda wa jada. Whoever is strive, he will get it. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُ. Whoever is strive for hidayah, it is not so easy that Allah will just give you without your desire. No. We have to strive for it. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا. Whoever is strive for it, Allah will make way for him. So who is ready for that, inshallah? That inshallah, I will learn this deen, practice on the, this is everybody's duty. To learn the deen, practice deen, propagate the deen. Are we all ready for that, inshallah? Make intention, inshallah. Allah bless you, inshallah.
Just like you said, inshallah, stay behind for a couple of more minutes, inshallah. And then we'll be doing time for Zulu and everything, inshallah. Performance, not with inshallah.